theory was created for scientific purposes. There are moments of dissection in the video. If you are an impressionable person, do not watch this video. Just recently, I received a small container that contained a frozen mantis shrimp. He got this name for obvious reasons. The whole point is that he has very similar limbs to the praying mantis. Even his body vaguely resembles the body of a praying mantis. The praying mantis shrimp that stuns its prey has a slightly different structure of the limbs. We'll also figure it out today. Mantis shrimp most often live in coral reefs. This is where they show their rivalry in the race for survival, because they are real born predators. They have a bright, beautiful color, and this is perhaps the only thing that can win your sympathy. Mantis shrimp are also prone to outbursts of aggression. These highly territorial arthropod sociopaths do not hesitate to pounce on anyone who gets close to them, inflicting heavy blows. The second pair of their pectoral limbs have been transformed into the most powerful melee weapons that exist in nature. The click caused by the mantis shrimp can leave a serious bruise or break the wall of the aquarium. With an average body size of 20 centimeters and a mass of about 100 grams, the impact force of these animals reaches 1,500 newtons, and the speed of limb movement is more than 20 meters per second. For comparison, the punch of Olympic-level boxers is 3,400 newtons and 9 meters per second. But they are in completely different weight categories. Not surprisingly, mantis shrimp are located at the top of the food pyramid of the coral reef. Now I'm starting to dissect one of the representatives of the praying mantis shrimp, and at the same time, I will tell you more about them, because this is really a unique creation. This vast group includes more than 450 species from 15 related families, which are divided into two groups according to the method of obtaining food. Our mantis shrimp belongs to the spearmen. The spearmen have working claws and an inch sharp and long points that are thrown out like the blade of a spring knife. These crayfish prefer to hunt by ambushing relatively soft prey, mostly fish, piercing them through with a single throw. The claws of the drummers resemble small and evil hammers, with which they, having previously tried on, break through the shells of mollusks. Having removed the upper scale from the back, which is called the carapace, we can immediately observe the nervous system of the praying mantis cancer. Next, I continue to open its tail. Despite the force of impact, mantis shrimp cannot boast of powerful triceps. Their harpoons and hammers are accelerated by ordinary mechanics. The process is similar to archery. Try throwing an arrow with your hand. You will never achieve such throwing power as when using a bow. Its elasticity allows you to slowly gain much more mechanical energy and throw it away with one relaxation of your fingers. And the elastic protein base allows it not to collapse and not crack even with severe deformation. The saddle bends in the longitudinal direction, the organic layer is stretched, and the entire structure accumulates elastic potential energy. This releases so much energy that short pulses of light flash in the water. For you, I have prepared several parts of the mantis shrimp, which we will examine under powerful microscope. This is what the tail of the mantis shrimps looks like. This is what swimming legs look like. blade-sharp jaws look like a huge saw under magnification. This is what scathosaurid looks like under a microscope. For those who do not understand what it is, I advise using Google to study the structure of mantis shrimp. This is what the cornea of the mantis shrimp looks like. The vision of the mantis shrimp is even more amazing than their striking technique, and is considered the most complex in the entire living world. They have only two eyes, but they move independently of each other, and three pupils blacken in each. This is what a telson looks like under a microscope. This is the tail of a mantis shrimp. For me personally, the tail part is very similar in structure to the tail of a shrimp. And even the smell of a defrosted mantis shrimp has a shrimp tone. This is what part of the brain looks like. This is chitin from the upper tail. I know that this release may seem complicated, and for this, I advise you to independently study the structure of mantis shrimp, and even better, read about them and watch a video with their hunting. These are truly unique creatures that deserve special attention. I hope I didn't overload you with information, and if you were interested, be sure to like this video.